went over this. So the part that's tricky to make it the full vinyasa flow is that after we come into our reverse namaste, we hold on to the swing for ladle, and then we sink our head down towards the ground. We wiggle the swing on top of our hips. It's really good to get it into a good position. Not below the hips, because you'll slide out. Okay, the key here is your hands come down, so palms down for this one. So you start to bring your legs wide and around. So it's really important that you can touch your toes. So your feet have to come in front. If you can't touch your toes, then you're not in the front plane. If your legs are here, that's the back plane. This is the side plane, and then this is the front plane. So go ahead and touch your toes before we go further so we know your feet are in the right place. And then once you've touched your toes, straighten the legs out, and then I want you to walk your hands towards me. So now we have our hands in a handstand position. Legs wide and heavy. This is an up dog. And then when we press our chest down, we can bend our elbows and then come into an upside down dog. So the elbows are bent, and I call it cobra, it makes it a little bit easier. This is up dog, this is upside down dog. And then when we pull our chest over the fingertips, we're gonna go ahead and release and come to sit. And that's the roundhouse flip. Yay, super fun. And now we enjoy this little bit of a swagger that's happening here. We're just gonna have the pendulum swing. And then we're gonna practice just coming right into it. So we're gonna skip the first half of the vinyasa flow. We're gonna lean back, bring our legs around wide, and then walk yourself forward. Just try it. It's nice to be able to go right into the roundhouse flip. So try it from the wide straddle. Good. And then when we pull forward, we're gonna release, do a sit up, and let yourself come back through floating Buddha. Isn't that fun?
Yes.
Yeah, super fun. Okay, so that's the extent of that, right? So if we wanted to get a little fancy with it, I'm gonna show you how to do some ollies. So from our ladle position, we slide down, bring the legs wide, walk your hands to the front of the mat, legs heavy. So I'm gonna just wiggle the swing into the sweet spot. I'm gonna plant my right hand in center, and I'm gonna touch my left toes. Switch sides, touch my right toes. So these are called ollies. So while we're here in our handstand wide straddle, we can have some fun with it. So this is a little bit more of a balance and a strengthener, but it's also really fun. And then when I wanna come back up, swing and sit.
Really nice, there you go. So your legs have to be nice and heavy, or you're gonna go into an alley-oop. An alley-oop is when you twist around. Really good. Nice, so just go for it, go towards it. Okay, great. So I'm gonna turn around so you can see me when I'm upside down. So I'm gonna show you how we can go from our floating Buddha into an inversion. Okay. A little bit easier to see this direction, so you guys can turn around too if you'd like. So what I'm going to do is from my ladle position, I'm going to get the swing into the sweet spot. This is where we get the swing position. And then I'm going to bring my legs wide and around, and I'm going to hook them in front. So remember we had to grab for our toes to make sure our feet were in the front plane. So always make sure your legs hook outside in, and then we're locked in at our hips. So this is called Peaceful Warrior. So we can just let ourselves hang out here. Feels really good. From Peaceful Warrior, I like to grab for the leg loops with my hands so I get them off my feet. My feet still stay hooked, and I put these in my elbow creases. So when they're in my elbow creases, I bring my hands to prayer. I press my hips forward, and I come into a happy Buddha. Really good. So leg loops are on the inside, hands are at the heart, and I push the hips forward a lot. Nice. To open up into archer, I'm gonna let my arms come open wide, and then I'm gonna bring
my hands open more to arch. Leg loops are on the outside of the knees. That's very important. Now from archer, I'm going to come into a skydiver position. This is a little bit more challenging. That's why we did those arm strengthening earlier. So I'm going to lift my chest and extend my legs at the same time. When I do that, I squeeze the leg loops onto my shoulders. So this is skydiver position. We're getting ready to come into our Superfly. Okay? So in the skydiver position, leg loops on the shoulders, swing still wrapped around the hips. I can bend the knees. Okay? So I'm going to bank a little from side to side, hang out here. So this might be as far as you want to go for today. And then if we want to come into the full Superfly, we're going to grab like a backpack underneath our arms, and then we're going to do a full extension out. And that's how we get into it. That's how we walk into it. To come out, we're going to reverse. We put the leg loops back onto the shoulders. And then we're going to bend the elbows back in. Archer. Happy Buddha. And then go ahead and slide into a wrist wrap and come down. I like the scissor kick down with control.